Breaking now, it is 10 o'clock Eastern time. The transcript from the call between President Trump and Ukraine's president, it has been released, and Blake Berman has seen it. He's gone through it. What do you got, Blake? Hey, Blake, you're on.
Stuart, five pages. Yep, I'm here. Sorry, going through it. Five pages long. Let me get to the headline on page four as it relates to Joe Biden and the conversations that President Trump had with Vladimir Zelensky on July 25th at around 9 a.m. in his call. Here's the quote from the five-page transcript. President Trump says, quote, "There's a lot of talk about Biden's son, that Biden stopped the prosecution, and a lot of people want to find out about that. So whatever you can do with the attorney general," meaning Attorney General Bill Barr, "would be great. Biden went around," the president says, "bragging that he stopped the prosecution. So if you can look into it, dot, 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 it sounds horrible to me." President Zelensky then responds, "He or she," meaning the upcoming new prosecutor, "will look into the situation." Very clearly there, Stuart, on page four of this transcript, President Trump asking the Ukrainian president, the newly elected Ukrainian president, to look into, at that time, his main, or one of his main potential Democratic rivals. Joe Biden was leading the field. Of course, as you know, President Trump has made the claim that Joe Biden used his position as then vice president to help benefit his son, Hunter Biden's, business dealings in Ukraine. I mentioned that this is five pages, Stuart. Let me just sort of tick you through them real quick, just so I can put everything in context here. 9:03 in the morning, July 25th, the call made from the White House residence. It starts off with President Trump congratulating Vladimir Zelensky on his recent win. Zelensky says, "We won big." There's some chit-chat between the two. Then the conversation on page two moves on to President Trump saying how he does a lot for Ukraine and that the U.S. does more than Germany. As you know, the president thinks there should be some burden sharing with Ukraine. President Zelensky then tells President Trump, "You're right." He agrees that Germany needs to do more. At that point, the president then shifts the issue to CrowdStrike and the DNC server. CrowdStrike was the company that was investigating the DNC server, which was hacked during the 2016 presidential election. Top of page three now, if you have that. Quote, it's long, let me read it. "I would like you to do a favor," President Trump says, "though, because our country has been through a lot and Ukraine knows a lot about it. I would like you to find out about what happened with this whole situation with Ukraine. They say CrowdStrike. I guess you have one of your wealthy people, the server. They say Ukraine has it. There are a lot of things that went on, the whole situation. I think you're surrounding yourself with some of the same people. I would like to have the Attorney General call or your people, and I would like you to get to the bottom of it." President Zelensky then says, it is a very important issue. That's page three. Page four then moves on to Joe Biden, the exchange which I just read to you, where the president says he wants Biden and his son to be looked at. Zelensky says he or she, the upcoming prosecutor, will look into it. Then shortly after that, the president says, quote, "I will have Mr. Giuliani give you a call, and I am also going to have the Attorney General Barr call, and we will get to the bottom of it. I'm sure you will figure it out. I heard the prosecutor was treated very badly, and he was a very fair prosecutor, so good luck with everything." The president there is referring to the former Ukrainian prosecutor who was let go, who was looking into the business dealings of a company in which Hunter Biden sat on the board, though the international community has noted that was not a fair prosecutor. Page five, the president then goes on to say, President Zelensky says, "I also want to assure you that we will be very serious about the case and we will work on the investigation." President Trump ends this exchange by saying, quote, "Good, well, thank you very much, and I appreciate that. I will tell Rudy Giuliani, and Attorney General Barr to call." So, Stuart, what are we to take away from this? Five pages, as you can see at the top, now says unclassified. The White House is going to make the argument that there is nothing in here that suggests a quid pro quo of $400 million of Ukrainian aid that had been delayed tied to an investigation into Joe and or Hunter Biden. That's part of the case they will make. They will also make the case that the media has gotten a lot of this reporting wrong. However, on the other side, this certainly gives Democrats fodder to say that the president of the United States had asked a foreign leader to to look into an investigation of, at that time, his main political rival and his main political rival's son. Nancy Pelosi yesterday, Stuart, you will remember, she very clearly said there doesn't need to be a quid pro quo. The fact that President Trump engaged in this conversation is why, or at least part of the reason why, they are leading an impeachment inquiry at this time against the president. Bottom line here, Stuart, an argument to be made on both sides, but Democrats are moving full steam ahead with this impeachment inquiry, as they say the president engaged in an improper conversation. One last thing to note, Stuart, if you don't mind real quick, you'll notice some of that language was choppy. Even though this is a quote-unquote transcript, this is not an exact word verbatim transcript. As it notes on the bottom, caution, a memorandum of telephone conversation is not a verbatim transcript of a discussion. The text in this document records the notes and recollection of Situation Room duty officers and national security policy staff assigned to listen and memorialize the conversation in written form as the conversation takes place. It's part of the reason why Democrats are saying they want the whistleblower complaint to be given to Congress, though also, Stuart, at this hour, the Department of Justice is about to outline the reasons as to why they do not believe legally that can be handed over.
Okay.
That's where this stands. If you have any questions, happy to take them.
I think you got it all in there, lad. It's up to us to sort this thing out. Okay, Blake, thank you very much indeed. To me, bottom line, no smoking gun.
No.
I think the Democrats will make a great deal of the fact that it is not a verbatim transcript of the what's it, the transcript. It's not a verbatim.
Of the conversation. Okay.